We've got some isolated thunderstorms heading our way today. Some will be on the stronger side this afternoon and tonight, and a little bit more widespread as we go throughout the next couple of days than what we've seen a couple of days ago. Good news is things get a little bit better as we head into the weekend, which is good news. We continue to track potential tropical cyclone 9. This is moving pretty quickly now as it's made its way over the Windward Islands, pushing west, continuing to see some tropical storm warnings up around Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. This, by the way, is on a track to the west, and the very latest weather model runs showing it coming a little bit more westward. So last night we had it kind of going into Miami. Today it sort of sideswiped portions of southern Florida. Now it's bringing it just a little bit more west, and it's weakening it just a little bit too. Earlier weather model runs suggested this could be upwards of 65 miles per hour. Now it looks like it's been downgraded to, say, 50 miles per hour. So a strong tropical storm as it makes its way toward Florida. At least that's what one model suggests. We have others that say, no, if it's able to stay together, it could actually make its way back out into the Atlantic. If it goes in the Atlantic versus the Gulf, it might be a little bit stronger, but still, either way, we're likely to at least get some wind and some rainfall no matter what direction it takes. If it stays going north into Florida, or if it stays on the Outer Banks coming into the Carolinas. So we'll be keeping a close eye. Still a lot of unknown with this system, but we're watching it very carefully. Across the region, things remain unsettled. We've got lots of scattered showers and thunderstorms firing up on Mississippi, Alabama. Some of those will be moving into our area later today. Could be on the stronger side, with the main threats today being those gusty winds, but we've had quite a bit of lightning embedded in a lot of these storms, so a couple of electrical thunderstorms absolutely possible as well. And these heavy downpours. The farther into the day we go, not only will we have the greatest heating, but we'll also have the greatest chance for some of these thunderstorms to become a bit more numerous. Notice even 7-8 o'clock tonight, we could still see some isolated thunderstorms around. Tomorrow will be similar, except even stronger. We have a cold front that's going to try to come through. It's going to stall out to our north, and we've got an area of low pressure tomorrow that's going to ride along that front, and that's going to provide some further instability. So strong storms, and if you get enough of those thunderstorms kind of back to back by Thursday or Friday, we could also be looking at some localized flooding. Temperature wise, we're going to be right at the seasonal average, or maybe even a little bit below that by the time Thursday rolls around for the first time in a long time. If you'd like to get out and about, Saturday and Sunday looks like we get into more isolated chances for some rainfall that moves back into the afternoon. Sunday looks to be the drier day, but by Sunday night into Monday, we start to see things ramp up again.